Our next guest has just arrived, and we're very pleased to have him here tonight as he's a partner for the event and very much been supportive to Odyssey and Polaris coming together. I would like to welcome to join us here tonight Mr. Raymond Knops, the Minister for the Interior and Kingdom Relations. Ladies and gentlemen. Good afternoon. So I've earlier welcomed everyone here, but wouldn't it be more appropriate for you to welcome everyone since this is at the heart of your courtyard here in the parliamentary buildings?
Yes, but you know I'm a member of the government, not of parliament, so I'm also a guest here, and I'm sure you did a better welcome than I can do. So yes, welcome to everybody being here.
Thank you very much, that's very kind.
In this Hall of Knights, in this very special location.
It's beautiful, it's beautiful. So it's fantastic to have you here this evening. You're a partner in Odyssey, and you're here to help us kick off this season at Polaris, at this event. You've also recently accepted another position within the cabinet as a minister, but even as a state secretary before then, you were already responsible for the digital transformation the government is going through and the challenges there, and the innovation agenda. So. Could you help us understand how we can help you with that, with the people here in the audience?
Well, it's not the first time for me being here amongst all these bright people from all over the world. And I must say, I am always very impressed by the creativity, the enthusiasm, and the way you work and deal with problems we also face as a government. So it's for us as a public entity very important to deal with all kinds of organizations all over the world, to find solutions for problems we face in the way we deal with our citizens. And as a state secretary or minister, it doesn't matter, it's the same job, and the one job is better paid than the other, but it's the same work.
Well, congratulations.
So, and less sleep maybe, but temporary. No, it's the same, my mission is the same. Try to do all the best in the interest of our people, and digitization, innovation can help us making society better to face the challenges we have all over the world. Climate change has mentioned already before, I'm sure, but also other challenges we face as a society. And it's the obligation of the government to do its utmost to help everybody to fulfill these demands. And being here for the second time now, but also on other hackathons as a spectator, I was impressed by the dynamics and the outcome and the output of all these meetings with all these people together. So when we can support it, and we do, by being part of it and not only be at the site and watching what you are doing, then we can be more effective. And that's the reason that a lot of civil servants also participate in these sessions, because to be part of this front group and to be part in the front group of innovation.
That's fantastic. And your enthusiasm also shows in your support of the Hackathon 2020. Again, you're part of, your teams are part of the hackathon. And you're leading a track, actually, with the Dutch Blockchain Coalition.
Yeah.
Here. Could you talk tell us more about that?
We have a very good relation with the Dutch Blockchain Coalition. And I must say, not only from the Ministry of Interior, but also the Ministry of Economic Affairs and Justice and Security, we have very strong connections, because the knowledge that is in that coalition and all the people that they bring together is very worthwhile for us in our work. And that's one of the reasons that next week I'm going to Singapore with the members of the Dutch Blockchain Coalition to see what we can learn from other countries, not only to take knowledge from there, but also to bring our positive experiences so far. And I think that's beneficial for everybody, not only for the people in the Netherlands, but also in Europe, where Europe is about in a discussion on human rights and how do you deal with privacy and security on the one hand, and the opportunities that digitization brings to society on the other hand. And these are really topics that have to be discussed here in Parliament, in government, in Europe, and what is nicer than to exchange all these best practices. So we are Saturday we are going to Singapore, and I'm very curious about what I see and learn there and bring it back to the Netherlands.
That's very interesting. And Singapore has also been very much at the forefront of some of these developments.
Absolutely.
With their e-identities and some other policies that they've implemented, yeah. Also in fintech. So it should be very inspirational. And you're bringing some startups on this delegation as well, I believe.
Yes.
Good.
Yeah.
Some of our innovators are going, so that's
Absolutely.
Good. Could you describe what we're doing radically different when it comes to the digital system of the 21st century? What do we have to do radically different? What is most top of mind for you?
Well, I think when I look into the debate that is held actually now in Dutch Parliament, it's about digital inclusion. How can we engage normal, ordinary people in society with all these fast-going developments? And we have to admit that some people, also in the Netherlands, it's estimated about 2.5 million people in our country, do have difficulties with catching up these speedy processes. So we have to help them. That's one thing. And I think that digitization, innovation can help us to bridge the gap also for them. So digitization can be a solution for people who have difficulties with digital devices and digital services. On the other hand, you see a strong wish for having more control on own data from the people in our country. So that makes that we have to to design systems that are suitable for changing your data and deciding yourselves whether you want to have your data shared with other public services. And this makes that we have to design our systems in another way, but also have to deal with all the challenges about privacy, because when somebody wants to have more influence and more control over their own data, how are we going to secure, on the other hand, the same data of that specific person? So quite some challenges. I think we can learn from other countries, but I'm not the person that is sitting behind and wait until there's somewhere a solution. No, I really believe that we together can achieve more, and that we can find solutions that are in the interest of everybody. And so if you ask what is your political agenda, that is the agenda. There is one way forward, that it's more, we have to face a world that's more complicated, more challenging. But on the other hand, people expect a lot of the government, and they want us to deliver as quick as possible, as safe as possible, and as accurate as possible. So that's
you're
quite
raising the bar.
Quite an endeavor.
It's quite an ambitious challenge you're looking at as well. So how can Odyssey 2020 help you with that? Any final words for people here on your expectations there?
What I said before, I witnessed a lot of these tracks already and a lot of these challenges. And what I really wanted to have in the near future is that we can show very practical to our citizens results of all these efforts that have been done so far and will be done in these sessions as well. And make it so the low-hanging fruit. It's very essential that what we are doing benefits and is visible for the ones who benefit from it. And when we can support you in your work and you can help us with finding solutions for questions, societal questions we have, I think then 1 + 1 = 3. And that's what I wanted to have.
Fantastic.
And that's my question to you.